everyone. I hope you're having a great day. Today I'm going to be showing you all how to make this cute, easy baby headband with a couple different variations. It's a really easy pattern, so let's get started. You will need a 24 peg round loom, two different balls of yarn of the same color, a pair of scissors, a hook, and a needle. The hook and the needle should come with your loom kit. To cast on, I'm just going to go ahead and e-wrap twice around my first peg and then knit that off and bring it down to the bottom of the peg. I'm going to continue this around the loom. So you e-wrap twice on one peg and then you take that bottom stitch and knit it over the top stitch. And you're just going to continue this all the way around the loom. It doesn't matter if you go clockwise or counterclockwise, as long as you keep the same direction. For this tutorial, I'm using an acrylic yarn. I'm using the Joann's Pearl Sensations. It's a great basic yarn. It's kind of a medium weight, so I like to use two strands to make it a little bit more bulky. However, if you're using a little bit more of a thick yarn, just feel free to use one strand. That should suffice. I just chose to do a purple yarn for this headband. I'll show you another headband later in the video that I made with a thick yarn where I just use one strand, and it's actually a blue headband. Once again, just continuing to cast on all the way around the loom. We're going to cast on all 24 pegs. Alright, so we're just finishing up that cast on here. You can see what it looks like so far. Now I'm just going to go ahead and start knitting. So I'm just going to e-wrap all of the way around the loom. I'm going to be doing a knit stitch, so in order to do that, you have to e-wrap all the way around the loom. So that's what I'm just doing here. And then I'm just going to knit off each peg. So just take that bottom loop and knit it over the top. Pretty basic, right? Hopefully you've knitted before. If you don't know how to knit, I do have a video that shows you how to do that. I'll link it below. For the next row, we're going to be doing a purl stitch all the way around the loom. What you do is you have your working yarn below your stitch. Take your stitch over your working yarn, pull it through, creating a loop. Take your stitch off your loom and put this new loop on. I have a complete video that just concentrates on the purl stitch and shows you step by step. If you haven't done a purl stitch before, I highly recommend you look at that first, because you'll probably be watching this and be very confused. But hopefully you've done a purl stitch before and are comfortable with it. It's a very good, versatile stitch, and we're gonna be using it a lot in today's video. Alright, so I'm just continuing my purl stitch here. I'm almost to the end of the row. Here I am back at the beginning. For the fourth row, I'm going to do another purl stitch. So just keep purling all the way around the loom. This is a great pattern to do if you need practice of working with the purl stitch. Like I mentioned earlier, I am going to be using it a lot in this video. So I'm just finishing it up here. Now I'm just going to pull down my knitting down to the bottom of the loom. this all the way around the loom. Once again, I'm e-wrapping the next peg. Now I'm going to go ahead and knit off that next peg. Then I'm just going to take that stitch and move it over one peg to the left. And then I'm just going to take the bottom stitch and move it over, knit it off, sorry. And then I'm going to take that stitch and move it over one peg to the right. And now you have completed another casting off. Once again, I'm just repeating this with the rest of the loom. Hopefully you like that little animation that I made there showing you step-by-step directions with pictures. If you need to revisit that, just please replay the video. I'll put links below to the times of when I started doing things. So far you can see the progress there of what I've cast off already. I like using this cast off because it just creates a really nice edge to the project. So I'm just going to continue casting off. Once again, e-wrapping, knitting off, moving this peg over to the peg to the left, knitting off that stitch, and then moving that stitch back over to the right and repeating around the loom. Not the word from your lips, just glancing, my heart skips. If this is still too complicated for you, which I can totally understand, sometimes it takes a little bit of practice, I do have another video that just shows you how to do this technique of a basic bind off or a basic cast off on a flat panel. I will link it below. So please, if you need more practice, watch that video. You know, sometimes you just have to keep doing it a couple times until you can get it. That's what I like with loom knitting, or just with knitting in general. If you screw something up, you can always just take your yarn out. You don't have to cut anything or lose any yarn. You can just take your yarn out and do it again. All right, so I'm just gonna give you another little quick update after I finish this one. All right, see what we got going so far? Doesn't that look nice and complete? I really like how this bind off or cast off, whatever you want to call it, looks. Once again, I'm just continuing. I'm casting off all pegs all the way around the loom. Skips. I need your love, it's so divine. It's our time to shine. It's our time to shine. Alright, so I'm getting to my last cast off right here. I just knitted off. Now I'm moving that stitch over one peg to the left, knitting off that peg, moving it back over to the right. Then I'm going to e-wrap and knit off that peg one more time. So I'm e-wrap, then knitting off. And then I'm just going to go ahead and cut a tail of yarn, usually at least over a foot long. Then I take that stitch off the loom. Here, I'm taking it off the loom. And I make it a little bit bigger so it's easier so I can kind of stick my fingers through it. And then I'm just going to pull that yarn tail through it. Just kind of pull it through so it makes it tight. And that's the final stitch. So that's your little headband. It's going to take a little bit of stretching out since you just took it off the loom, excuse me, so just give it a second to kind of stretch it out. Look how nice that edging looks though on it. You know, that's why I like to use these kind of cast-ons and cast-offs. Now I'm just going to take my needle and thread my tail of yarn just to reinforce the last where we just kind of bound off. You can kind of see the seam, if you will, of where we started and ended. So I'm just going to reinforce this area between the end of the row and the beginning of the row. So that's what I'm just doing with my needle here. Completely optional. I just, you know, obviously want to keep it as reinforced as possible. Once you've done that, just kind of tie a little knot there and then trim off any ends. Once again, I'm just tying a knot again, and then I'm going to trim that end. Now I just like, this is completely optional, I like to pull apart the stitches of the first and the last row. Just kind of adds for a little bit of added width for the headband, excuse me. Completely optional step, you don't have to do this. It's just kind of a technique I learned not too long ago, and I thought it was a really cool idea, and I never thought to kind of pull apart the stitches of my first and last row to make it wider. You can really see the row where you cast on, you get a bigger difference with this. So here are my two finished projects. I just added little flowers to these. Are these cute or what? There's a little pink flower and then a little white flower. I do have a video showing you how to make these flowers and attach them to the headband, so check that out below. This is a blue headband that I made with a little bit of a bigger loom. I just used one strand of yarn and attached three flowers there. Aren't those cute? So that's just another option to the pattern. Instead of just doing, I just did two extra rows, so it was a little bit wider too. So see, these two I made with the 24 peg loom. This one I actually made with the 32 peg loom, excuse me. And I just added two extra rows, so it would be a little bit thicker as well. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. Check us out on Facebook.